record number of people cast ballots in the first week of early voting in Tennessee and Georgia. I'm Josh Rowe.
And I'm Kayla Strayer. This is a picture from Whitfield County showing a long line of people waiting to cast their ballot at the courthouse. One of the biggest races people are keeping an eye on right now, of course, the race for the next governor in Georgia.
Today, Georgia's Democratic candidate for governor took her early vote bus tour to Whitfield County. Allie Levine was there and joins us now live from one of the polling locations in that county. Allie, what was Abrams' message today?
Well, Josh and Kayla, Stacey Abrams' message was a simple one. Get out and vote, and vote early. Hundreds came out to watch her speak, and many of them had either just come from the polls or were heading that way shortly after. In the first week of early voting in Georgia, enthusiasm is high. Outside, a crowd gathers in Dalton to hear Democratic gubernatorial hopeful Stacey Abrams share an important message.
So we've got to do what?
Meanwhile, just down the street, the line to vote at the Whitfield County Courthouse reflects a trend toward record turnout.
To see something like this, this reminds me of a presidential election. This is just mind-boggling.
Lara Haney tries to vote in every election. She's what's considered a likely voter.
I'm not counting on just likely voters. I'm counting on unlikely voters.
And this midterm is expected to bring many of them to the polls.
I think indeed that we are seeing numbers of people who are voting not just early, but who've never voted in midterms before.
Each for their own reason.
Because they're tired of being oppressed.
Because I was already sure of my choices, already knew who the candidates were, which I'd already know, did my research.
I just think a lot of people are fed up on both sides. For different reasons, obviously.
While some see this turnout as a positive indicator of democracy,
voting means to me that we should all have a voice.
Others view the line as a reflection of recent rhetoric across the country.
This is a sign of the anger and divisiveness that you hear about. This is a prime example.
So in this first week of early voting in Georgia, 2,370 people voted here in Whitfield County. And I do want to give you some other numbers that we just got in from this first week of voting in areas around North Georgia counties, in our viewing area rather. In Catoosa County, 3,981 people voted this first week. Get this, in the 3 weeks of early voting in 2014, 5,030 people voted. So well on pace to surpass that number. In Dade County, early voting is up 228%. And in Murray County, it is up 359%. So you can see those record-breaking numbers coming in so far in early voting this early season. Reporting live in Whitfield County, I'm Allie Levine, News Channel 9.
Great to see those high numbers, Allie. Thanks so much. And in Georgia, early voting ends November 2nd. In Tennessee, early voting ends November 1st. Election day, of course, November 6th.